Good evening and welcome to Southmont High School tonight here on MTC Sports, presented by Endeavor Communications. It's IHSAA Boys Basketball Sectional 44 matchup. It's a semifinal round, features the Southmont Mounties and the Monrovia Bulldogs. Tonight, Pete Gashel, Sean Walker will be calling the game for you. And tonight, Pete, as I was getting ready to lead in, I almost forgot to introduce us. Southmont will actually be the visiting team on their home floor. You get that sometimes in sectional play. It's the way it works out. They got the first round bye. Monrovia defeated Cascade the other night. Monrovia will be the home team here against Southmont on their home floor. It looks to be a good semifinal game.
It looks to be an excellent semifinal game, and I think we'll have two very good games here tonight, and I think it's a great basketball for this time of year, and I'll tell you what, I'm excited. I'm fired up tonight.
For Monrovia the other night, they definitely came in and took care of business, avenging an earlier loss on the season to Cascade. And they've got a couple of players over there that are really impressive. It starts with the junior guard in Luke Smith. He's pretty tough.
Yeah, Luke Smith averages 20.8 points per game. And he's an awesome player. You know, it's one of those players that the other team says, hey, that's the guy we got to watch out for. You got to get a hand in his face, make him shoot contested shots.
Let's take a look, if we could, at sectional 44 in the bracket real quick. Show you what transpired on Tuesday night. We already told you, Cascade and Monrovia squared off. Monrovia able to come out of there with the win. North Putnam and Cloverdale were in that second game of the evening that we covered for you. Cloverdale with an easy win. They'll move on to take South Putnam tonight. So we'll have both of these games for you, set to tip off right around 6 p.m. with game number one. Game number two will follow at approximately 7:30. The winners from tonight, they'll face off tomorrow night in a winner-take-all sectional championship that we'll have for you again right here live on MTC Sports. Let's talk about our keys to victory, if we could. Let's bring those up. And, Pete, tell me what the two teams need to do to have a great game here tonight and come out with a victory.
Well, when you're trying to make it to that final game here, you want to limit your turnovers. Both teams need to be really conscious of this. No silly turnovers here. Number two is you got to control the tempo. One thing that Southmont's got to realize is that when Monrovia scores 60 or more points, they win almost every game. So they need to really, for Southmont, control the tempo there, slow things down, play their game, and try to make Monrovia get into their game. And then just to win a sectional title, it just comes down to this. Both teams shoot the ball well. Right there, you got to shoot the ball well to move on.
You can't have a cold shooting night this late in the season. I love it. Our keys to victory brought to us by Endeavor E-Tech. Monrovia has come back out on the floor to continue their pregame warm-ups. And with that, let's talk about their impact player tonight. We'll do it a little out of order. Impact player from Monrovia tonight is?
Sure, that's number 10, Luke Smith. We were just talking about it. He's the junior guard, 6 foot, averages 20.8 points per game, and he shoots 89% from the free throw line. He's dangerous there.
You see the Monrovia Bulldogs warming up. Luke Smith was unstoppable for him the other night. Really set the tone for those Monrovia Bulldogs and helped them avenge that earlier season loss against Cascade with a win the other night. These two teams have not faced off this year in the regular season. However, Southmont comes in 2-1 versus sectional opponents. Their only loss to Cloverdale back on December 5th. That one is 67-58.
I don't know if these teams have ever met. I went back and John Harrell's back as far as back as I could go, and I didn't see him playing at all, so it should be a very fun matchup.
For the Mounties, let's talk about them and their impact player tonight.
For the Mounties, you got number 13. He's a sophomore guard. Camden Chad, 6'1", 18.8 points per game, and gets 5.4 rebounds.
Be fun to watch them. I love the Southmont Mounties mascot, man. That is a great thing to be seen on the screen.
Kind of looks like me with my shirt off.
You wish. Couple of fans in the stands getting ready to take in this, what is essentially a home game for Southmont, even though they'll be wearing the visitor uniforms. They'll be the visitors on the scoreboard for all intents and purposes. You hear the band rocking right now. That's the Southmont band. They are located about 10 feet from me, and I may be deaf by the time we get into game number two. So if this sounds like I'm yelling at you, I apologize. Pete, it's always fun this time of year. There's been a lot of good games and matchups that took place on Tuesday. You know, you had some good teams that lost first-round matchups that are out. You think about Arsenal Tech already gone, and, you know, you have Mr. Basketball candidate and C.J. Walker, who now gets to watch the rest of the tournament from the sidelines. you got a team that kind of surprised a lot of people and played really, really well this year in Clinton Prairie. They lost by 2 points the other night to Central Catholic, and their season is now over. Yet a team like Tri-County loses in overtime on a last-second shot to North White. Tri-County had aspirations of winning the sectional championship. Southport defeated Pike in a first-round matchup that many thought would be the sectional championship game. Are you or are you not a fan of the ping pong ball blind draw? Do you think that they should continue to do it that way for the IHSAA, or should they seed them based off their records in the regular season?
I like it because it's fair. It's just a blind draw, and it's a fair way of doing it. You're always going to have those matchups that are going to be like this, you know, and what if you get a good conference sometime that in this everybody's got a winning record in there, you know, and really, to me, I think on any given night, any of these teams can step up and win, whether they're playing the best team or they're playing, you know, the second best team. That everybody's capable of winning on this floor here tonight.
That's going to do it for our Endeavor pregame show. When we come back, starting lineups and tip-off here, you're watching IHSAA sectional coverage of Sectional 44 at Southmont High School on MTC Sports.
Lightning fast high-speed internet is only a click away. Through fiber optic technology, Endeavor Communications is able to offer internet speeds up to 1,000 megabits per second to stream movies, download music, watch TV and video clips, connect on social media, play games online, conduct online video conferencing, and is ideal for supporting all your devices in your home or business. Call 1-800-922-6677 or visit our website at weendeavor.com for more details.
Endeavor eTechs provides outstanding IT and computer-related services for your home or business. Whether you need a simple home PC tune-up or a large-scale network installation for your business or your municipality, Endeavor eTechs is your final destination for all of your IT needs. Maintenance agreements are available and services open to members and non-members alike. Call 1-877-524-9109 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details.
Welcome back here to Southmont High School on MTC Sports Sectional 44 coverage. Brought to us by Endeavor Communications. Southmont Mounties, Monrovia Bulldogs set to do work. Starting lineups first for your visitors. The Southmont Mounties looks like this. Camden Chad, our impact player for tonight's game. It'll be Jarrett Todd, Andrew Travers, Jacob Budd, and Caleb Swick. Got the four forward starting lineup. John Sparks, 35-53 overall record. Those Mounties to try to get a victory here on their home floor. The other team they're facing tonight, the Monrovia Bulldogs, their starting lineup will be John Williams. He was our player of the game the other night for the work he did at the free throw line. They're in that fourth quarter. Luke
Phenomenal
Smith,
night.
He's our impact player. Trevor Eisenhoop, Luke Sieber, and McCoy Davis. Head coach Mike Elliott, 28-64. I saw him before the game. I said, Coach, how are the guys? Are they ready to go? And he said, I hope so. He said, I love my team, but I never know what I'm going to get. Sometimes they show them, they look great. Sometimes they come out flat. He's hoping for a quick start for him tonight.
Well, John Williams, he went 4-for-4 at the free throw line last night in the fourth period to close that thing out. So he was money at the end there.
That's a young man that only shoots 54% from the free throw line, and he was 100%.
Yeah, 100%. Had 15 points that night.
Set to jump it up, a couple of 33s. It'll be Caleb Swick and McCoy Davis. Just like that, basketball action is underway.
Is it the real McCoy?
It is the real McCoy. Chad snagged it there for Southmont, and they'll look to set up their offense first. Haven't seen the Mounties this year. We've got to see every other team in this sectional draw. See our first look at them. First drive, no good. Rebound secured by Smith.
Nice job by Monrovia protecting the paint inside.
Williams a little reluctant to let it fly early on. Eisenhoop. Saw him handle a lot of the ball handling responsibilities the other night for Monrovia. They go back door. Read beautifully by Southmont. We got our first turnover of the game. First three-pointer. A little bit short. Sieber with the board. Smith, crossover, foot on the line.
Can't get the roll.
That shot no good. Southmont quickly down the other way. Zwick with it now. Second leading scorer on this team is number 33 for Southmont. A little over 13 points per game. Up 7 rebounds per game as well. He's a glass cleaner.
Southmont being very patient.
Eisenhut got away with a foul there.
He did, right over the top.
Zwick, 3. And that's what they want to see. He's got great size, can go inside, Pete, but he shoots 43% from behind the arc.
Well, he was wide open, Sean, and squared up. You don't miss him when you're that wide open.
Eisenhut looks to penetrate.
He's got some build on him, too, you know.
Southmont Mounties, this is a beautiful school. Got a nice workout facility just outside the gymnasium here.
Yeah, beautiful pool behind us. Get too hot up here, we go cool down for a little while.
Little victory dip maybe. That shot off the mark. Todd with the rebound. Southmont will slow it up. 2 minutes gone by. Oh, we score 3-0 right now. The mid-range jump shot. It's up. Woo! And it's good as well. These Mounties taking advantage of that home floor. Five nothing early. Williams dribbles in to the trouble. Eisenhut gonna let a three fly. We saw him knock down a couple of those the other night. Zwick with his first board. He's gonna go all the way here. Didn't get it to drop. Last touch by Southmont. Should be Monrovia basketball.
Yeah,
and it
that'll stay there.
We saw Monrovia get out to a hot start the other night, and it was Luke Smith who really got him going. In that first quarter, he had 11 points. This one taken away. Near foul, near carry, neither called.
Yeah, they wanted a carry on that one. Oh, wide Swick, open.
All the way to the bucket and can't finish. McCoy with the rebound. I tell you, I thought Swick maybe should have thrown that one down, Pete. Looked like he was up high enough.
He had it. I mean, lane was wide open there. Just couldn't finish.
Keeper out top. Eisenhut finds Smith on a curl. Southmont doing a good job closing out on shooters. Other than the few turnovers, whistle-free contest as far as fouls are concerned so far. Eisenhut being hounded out top. Good defense by Travers.
Yeah, but good hustle. Get over that free ball.
4 minutes to go here in the first.
But how about the defense here from Southmont? I mean, they are getting out on shooters, like you said. They're extending it out, not letting anybody get in the lane. Look at them crash down.
Eisenhut with a tough contested shot.
Great block out, too.
Got a couple of substitutions set to check in at the scorer's table.
Oh, nice.
Mid-range jumper.
Oh!
Leaves it a little short. Mentioned a moment ago, Smith with 11 points in the first quarter.
Oh!
Tough shot there. Somehow gets it to go.
You've got to be kidding me.
On cue, he gets one to drop. Smith with the circus shot. Quick. That one knocked out of bounds by Eisenhut. Substitutions will come in. You got a pair coming in for Southmont. It'll be Nathaniel Farabee and Andrew Gregg.
But I had to replay right there. Didn't quite get to see the ending of that one, but that was something else. I think he was hoping they'd get the contact.
Max Newman checked in for Monrovia. Floater in the lane. You can count that one. That's Travers with his first field goal. Did it 7-2 early. Nothing coming easy for Monrovia.
That's a wide open shot. Just could not get it to go.
Southmont looking to spread the floor here. Monrovia in that man-to-man defense. Didn't see him play a ton of zone the other night. is the first turnover for Southmont on a traveling violation.
Yep, shuffle those feet before he put the ball down.
South Putnam Eagles in the house.
So far, though, Southmont doing a very good job of taking care of the ball. Playing good defense, not turning the ball over.
Siever with it out top. Williams back to Siever. Wyatt tonight so far held scoreless as well. Smith. No dice. Swick with another rebound. Everything contested right now from Monrovia, Pete.
Yeah, I think they're expecting to get some calls too, and they haven't been getting them. They're letting them play for the most part. See if we get our first foul.
This foul's against Max Newman of Monrovia. His first, team's first, game's first. And then the Swick.
Oh.
Nice drive to the bucket. Oh. Smith there with the block, though. Williams thought about it. Takes the shot, and it's off the mark.
Yeah, felt like he rushed. I mean, he had plenty of time out there and kind of leaning forward and really didn't have himself in a good set position.
Back out to Swick. They move it around. That's Greg for three. No good. See, we talked about holding Monrovia under 60. Every time they get to 60, they seem to win. They've got 2 points here in the first 7 minutes of the first quarter. Newman with the rebound, put back, too strong. Can't tap it in either. Sparks not elected to hold for one here. Evers runs out of real estate, gotta find some help. You're going to get 3 second call in the lane. That's why as a ball handler, if you pick up your dribble, you have to put it up as a shot.
One more time, just nowhere to go. He did have help behind him, he just nobody talking at that point. Your teammates, they got to realize that, you know, that get in there and help your buddies out.
23, Jacob Budd checks back in for the Mounties. Under 30 seconds to play first quarter. Coach Elliott gonna ask him to hold for one here. Get a big shot, a final play to get a bucket to go to give him some momentum going into the second. 5 seconds to play. Newman's got to force one up.
Oh, could not get it.
And that's how the first quarter will end. 7-2 your score. It's a low-scoring affair from Sectional 44 in Southmont High School. Back with more basketball right after this.
Watch TV Everywhere is a value-added entertainment option which gives Endeavor Television subscribers the ability to watch TV programs on their PC, laptop, tablet, or smartphone. When you subscribe to an Endeavor TV package, you receive select TV programming that is available in that package free of charge. You can view Watch TV Everywhere programs just about anywhere. All you need is an internet or Wi-Fi connection. Call 1-800-922-6677 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details about Watch TV Everywhere.
Want to know what I like best about playing basketball for my high school? I like it because it's a place where my friends get to see me play. I like it because I'm playing for someone besides myself. I'm playing for everybody in my school and every person in my community.
Indiana High School Sports. They're more than just a game.
Come and see me play.
Seven to two looks more like a baseball score right now than it does a basketball score after the first quarter of action. Southmont takes care of business in the first. They lead by five. Monrovia, just one field goal. It was a circus shot by Luke Smith. There's the Mountie patrolling the sideline. You gotta look at that. That is an awesome mascot.
John, we talked about Southmont playing their game and slowing it down, and they've done that so far. They've not allowed the Monrovia to get comfortable. They're just doing a really good job. See if they can continue this in the first half.
Monrovia held for the final shot of the first, couldn't get it to go, so no two for one. That's a reference you hear in football a lot at the end of the half. You hear it in NBA basketball. They'll do that when the clock's rolling down. Seaver.
Oh,
gets
got
it to go, and that's what they need. Luke Seaver stepping up with a bucket. Look at this take, Pete.
Really not much of a foul there, mostly body, but.
Definitely the height and the strength to play through the contact that was there. Gets the free throw to go as well. Now 7-5, three-point play just like that makes it a one-possession game. Get it back out top to Swick. Southmont, has definitely slowed things down. That's a nice interior pass here. There's a foul.
John Williams just got up and off his feet. Out got taken out.
Southmont's been very methodical so far. They've got a game plan, and you can see it. McCoy Davis comes back in. Oh, he had him wide open, too. Able to recover.
That's quick to recover like that.
Give you another football turn. Keep your head on a swivel.
Needed that one, right?
Rovia starting to extend their defensive pressure a little further out on the floor. Trying to force Southmont to speed up, and they get a turnover.
There you go. Southmont has not turned the ball over very much. And that pressure right there. Boswell, now you got to get down and you got to get some points off these turnovers.
Do you expect to see Monrovia go to a full court press or anything like that to try to speed the tempo of the game up?
I would say I would love to see it. I think it would play in their favor.
Davis over to Williams. They look for Sieber down low.
It's so hard to say because we haven't seen Southmont play that much, you know, so.
Eisenhut out top, looking for Williams, about threw it away. Sieber baseline, pull up jumper. Can't get that one to go. Battle for the rebound, controlled by Swick. This knocked out of bounds. They're going to say Monrovia basketball. No, Southmont basketball. Substitution coming in. It's number 22, Andrew Travers. Check back in for the Mounties. He'll spell Jarrett Todd. Good look at Coach Micah Elliott. Coach Elliott in his fourth year at Monrovia.
What a move.
Camden Chad with the field goal, his first of the game. Averaging almost 19 points per, and that's the first field goal coming here in the second quarter.
Yeah, some of their leading scorers, both teams' leading scorers, kind of held in check right now.
Eisenhut thought about it, extra pass is a good one. Sieber just short. Tipped out to Smith.
Oh, that's deep.
Oh. He can't get it to go either, but Sieber's there to track it down. Extra possession from Monrovia.
Good pass. Oh, wide open.
Williams floater in the lane, can't get it to go.
Look at him crash the
Davis
board, still working.
Can't get it to go, it's like there's a lid on this end.
Wow, four tries.
Good pass here, the kick out. That shot in and out. Maybe there's a lid on both ends at the moment. 9-5. Sounds like banker's hours right now.
Exactly.
4:50 to go here.
A little more spark now.
Pull-up jumper for Smith. And that's what they got to find a way to get him going.
Boy, that was pretty.
4 points for Smith. Monrovia back to within two. This dribble drive all the way to the rim. Can't convert. Swick taps it to himself. Williams there almost as like a gnat. Bugging Swick. Getting for a foul. That's number two on Williams. I apologize. They got it as number one up there. I had him for an earlier foul.
That's two on him. Unless they took it away, but I know he had one. We'll see if they don't get that changed. Gravel.
Traveling violation. Turnover gives Monrovia the ball back with a chance to tie or take the lead. Todd comes back in. Chad will come out. At the half, as always, I have a halftime show for you. Breakdown, show you some of the highlights of the first half of action. Get you the leading scores. I would say expert analysis, but I don't know if I want to go that far. Double team coming, trying to get the ball out of Smith's hands. Eisenhu puts it on the deck, gets to the in the lane, and can't convert. Smith gambles on the steal, can't get it all the way to the bucket.
Nice.
And that infuriates some of the fans that are here from Monrovia. Don't get a call on either end. Swick come, they get it away from Smith again.
It's kind of hard to figure out the referees right now for these players, you know.
Williams. Shot goes in the lane. 11-9.
But they're letting them play for the most part.
Yeah, three total fouls called in this game so far.
Look at that.
Swick gets away with a push-off. Down the lane, Travers kick out.
That one could have been called.
Swick being double-teamed out top. Eisenhut. And they get him for the push-off this time.
How about that?
I thought that was a good call by the official there. They missed it a moment ago. They didn't let him extend the arm for a second time.
Yep, they said, you do it again, we're going to get you.
That's Swick's second foul. He's going to come out for probably, you would think, at least the remainder of the second quarter. It's their leading scorer. Let's see if Monrovia can take advantage of this. Circle that. 3:02 of the second quarter. Zach Cottrell in for Monrovia. There's number four. Number 31, Dalton Smith in there as well. Smith upset. Team not running the play that was called. Now they get going. In the lane, kick out. Williams, three. Got it. And just like that, Monrovia has got the lead. 5 points for Williams, all of them here in the second quarter.
It took a while, but it got in there now.
For the backdoor lob, wasn't there. Monrovia really overextending on defense. Take away and then taken right back. The save by Smith, right to Travers. Physical contact. I think they're going to give the block here.
Yeah, it's a block. Yep.
And Micah Elliott wants a word with the official. I don't know if I blame him here. I'll send Travers to the line. They're going to say it's a shooting foul. Travers, a 67% free throw shooter on the season. There's a good conversation going on with Coach Elliott and the official. Travers' first free throw, no good. Four substitutions coming back in, trying to keep fresh bodies. It's Bud coming back in for Southmont.
Eisenhut comes back in from Monrovia. Coy Davis going to check back in as well. With the original starting five back on the floor from Monrovia. There's a good look at Andrew Travers. Averages almost 8 points per game. Rattles it home. He's got five so far here in this one. We're all knotted up at 12 again. It's over to Williams. We saw Monrovia's offense get stagnant at times the other night against Cascade, which is what allowed Cascade to kind of hang around. We're starting to see some of that again, where the plays are just taking a long time to develop and get into the offense. Smith contests a three, no good. Travers going to let a three go. He's had the high hand. Why not?
Nice.
Averages 8 points per game. He's got eight in the first half. Just like that, Southmont regains the lead by three. Williams hands off to Smith, and immediately double team comes. They're making it hard on him. Third rebound for Greg off the bench here for Southmont. Floater in the lane, no good. See if they run that double team and try to get the ball out of Smith's hand again. He's going to get blocked. But a foul on the follow through. It'll be Bud. It's his first.
Yeah, I think they got Jacob Bud, number 23. Only his first foul. Only three team fouls for each team.
Smith gets the first to go. He's got five in the game.
The coach is just substituting in and out like crazy, offense and defense.
Smith gets them both at the line. He's got six. It's a one-point lead now for Monrovia. Let's see if Southmont holds for the final shot of the half. Drive penetration. Not going to wait for the buzzer. Goes ahead and puts it up.
Wow, nice
rebound. No. Second time's good.
That's right.
Chad with only his second field goal of the game. 30-second timeout will be taken. Southmont will take the timeout. They'll try to set up their defense here. Again, if you're watching at home, two games headed your way tonight. This, obviously, game number one, Southmont Monrovia. Game number two features the South Putnam Eagles, the Cloverdale Clovers. You'll get another good look at two really good players, and they're both young as well. Cooper Neese, a junior, still has another year to go at Cloverdale. Already committed to go play college basketball at Butler University. On the other side, we'll get to see a good freshman in Alan Plunkett. 6'4", nice size, good scorer. We saw him in the Putnam County Tournament. He can get it going tonight. It may cause some trouble for Cloverdale.
Yeah, both those teams can both those players can light it up. And both of those teams need those players to get hot here tonight, that's for sure.
Plunkett's got to find his dynamic duo partner tonight. He's averaging 18 points per game this season against Cloverdale. Both of those games, though, losses.
Yeah, they're going to need like a Jimmy Rutter or a Dalton Scott to step up tonight.
Approaching the 5-second mark. Seaver has it knocked out of his hands.
Bully. 4 seconds. Got plenty of time to get it in, get a good shot off.
What kind of action?
Oh,
they
I love
it's
it.
A lob.
Oh.
Seaver, no. And that's going to do it for the first half of basketball. It has come and went quickly. 17-14. A low-scoring affair. We'll be back with a halftime show on MTC Sports presented by Endeavor Communications.
Endeavor eShield gives you peace of mind that your home, family, and business are safe. eShield provides burglar protection, leak detection, carbon monoxide, smoke and heat detection, and asset protection to secure your valuables. And of course, there's 24/7 monitoring. Total Connect Remote Services controls your system through your smartphone, tablet, or any other wireless device. Call 1-800-922-6677 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details. Endeavor Communications, we protect what you cherish most. Enjoy the freedom of independent living with Endeavor's Medical Alert System. Contact Emergency Help or a loved one directly through the water-resistant two-way voice pendant. It's as easy as pressing a button to call for help in and around your home. The Medical Alert System is easy to use and connects directly to your landline telephone. Call 1-800-922-6677 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details. Endeavor Communications, we help protect what you cherish most. Endeavor eShield gives you peace of mind that your home, family, and business are safe. eShield provides burglar protection, leak detection, carbon monoxide, smoke and heat detection, and asset protection to secure your valuables. And of course, there's 24/7 monitoring. Total Connect Remote Services controls your system through your smartphone, tablet, or any other wireless device. Call 1-800-922-6677 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details. Endeavor Communications, we protect what you cherish most.
It's halftime here at Southmont High School. The Mounties on top by 3 over Monrovia. What has been an entertaining first half, but a low-scoring first half so far. Sean Walker, Pete Gasho here. Set the stage for you. This halftime matchup, like I just alluded to, Pete, has been interesting. Not a lot of shots falling for either team so far.
You know, for Southmont, it's been about their game. They want to come out and play their game, you know, get their style of basketball going. To me, they've been successful at doing that. They wanted to keep it a low-scoring game. Anytime that Monrovia scores 60 or more points, they've won this year. It's going to be hard to score 60 here tonight.
Four guys in the scoring column for Southmont early on. They're led in scoring by Andrew Travers. He's got 8. That's his average on the season, so that's a good showing for him, especially when your top two scorers in Camden Chad and Caleb Swick have 7 points combined in the first half. Jarrett Todd pitched in a field goal as well in the first quarter. On the other side for Monrovia, it's 6 points for Luke Smith, 5 for John Williams, and 3 for Luke Siebert. Other than that, that's it. 3 guys in the scoring column for Monrovia. Any adjustments you see out there on the floor, Pete, that either of these teams will make at halftime?
We were talking a little earlier, you know, and I said I'd like to see Monrovia make an effort to try to go inside a little bit, maybe try to get Eisenhut involved and Luke Sieber down low. He's probably one of their taller players out there. I believe he's 6'5". And if they can't get anything down low, you know, then kick it back out. I love the way Southmont's playing right now. Really, I really think they have come out and established their game plan and they've stuck to it. I think in the dressing room, that's probably what they talked about. Let's keep it up, guys. We got the lead.
I'd be interested on Monrovia's side to see what adjustments they do make at the half. We talked in the first half about potentially bringing a full court press and trying to speed the game up and get the pace to where they want it. The other thing that I noticed in the game tonight is they got Luke Smith doing a lot of ball handling. And, you know, they have other capable ball handlers in Williams and Eisenhut because every time Smith brings it up, they send 2 guys quickly to double team to get it out of his hand. And so far, they've done a good job of taking him out of the game. Everything he's gotten tonight has been contested. I mean, two of his 6 points was a circus shot that really was just thrown up on a prayer.
I don't think you can keep Luke Smith from scoring all night long. I think he's going to get his points, or he's going to get close to his points, but no matter where he's at, you know, I think you do got to get a, you got to get a hand in his face, and if he's going to shoot him from the outside, you know, you just got to contest almost every shot. You saw what he can do with the circus shot, and that's just throwing it up on a wing and a prayer, and it goes in, you know. So he gets set. He can be dangerous from out there.
That's going to do it for the halftime show. Endeavor E-Shield Security Solutions. Give them a call. Check them out on their website. John Walker, Pete Gashill. We're going to step aside when we come back. Third quarter action headed your way from Sectional 44.
Experience the exciting world of television entertainment with Endeavor ETV. Get more than 350 quality TV channels, including HD, movies, sports, family programming, lifestyle, and local news and weather. Never miss a program with Endeavor Whole Home DVR. Stop a program in one room and continue watching TV in another. Enjoy video on demand and pay-per-view selections with over 2,000 titles. Call 1-800-922-6677 or visit our website at weendeavor.com for more details.
Welcome back here to Sectional 44 on MTC Sports, presented by Endeavor Communications. 17-14, your score. The Mounties on top of Monrovia, and they'll start with the basketball first here in the second half. This game one of two that we'll bring you, part of our live coverage. We have the sectionals for you this week. Next week, we will have regionals. We don't know where we're going yet, depending on winners and how things shake out. The following week, semi-state. And then we'll become viewers just like the rest of you as you get a first foul here on the state finals.
And right away, that kind of set the tempo for the players here as a little touch foul. We got Davis.
Davis, just his first foul. Wonder if the officials had a meeting at halftime and said, hey, guys, we only called three or four total fouls there in the first half. Maybe we should pick things up here in a second.
Yeah, I don't know if they do that, but that budget, it was brought up. Wow, that was great play. Almost got a clean block out of it.
The foul's going to send.
Take a look again here, Sean, on the replay. Good look inside. May have got him right on the hand.
Jacob Budd will go to the free throw line. 75% free throw shooter on the season. He makes easy work of the first. Budd, the only starter for Southmont that was held scoreless in the first half. Now he's in the scoring column as well.
That's the way you do it right there.
This lead out to 5 points now, Monrovia. Have Eisenhut bring it up this time. See if they still continue to send double teams when Smith touches the basketball. Nothing doing so far. Eisenhut baseline, gets blocked. Players on the floor. Davis took a shot, and he is, I think he's cut pretty bad. This is going to take a break in the action for sure.
Yeah, he caught something to the eye. Grabbed the ball and was smart enough to get the timeout. Man, he took a shot too. They'll get him cleaned up on the sidelines. Probably clean the floor up. This will probably take a little bit, Sean.
Yeah, that young man, as quickly as that went, you can only assume that he's going to need some kind of sutures. I didn't see where the shot took place, but I knew he knew it immediately. It's one of those things that he just laid on the basketball and put a hand on his eye.
Yeah, but that's quick. I mean, he grabbed the ball, you know, and he got the timeout too. I mean, that's some heads up right there for a player. That's a tough kid.
Shout out to the fans in the stands. Let's take a quick break in the action. We'll go to a commercial break. They're still going to have to get the floor cleaned up here and attend to McCoy Davis as he'll head off and head to the locker room. We'll be back with more coverage right here after this.
Control your thermostat, door locks, and lights with your Endeavor E-Shield security system. Save energy by remotely controlling your lights and adjusting your thermostat's heating or cooling while you're away with Honeywell Total Connect. Forget to lock your door? No problem.
Lock your doors remotely with a touch of a button from your smartphone or wireless device. Call 1-800-922-6677 for a free home and energy management system quote or visit our website at weendeavor.com for more details.
Wow. College already.
Yeah. We gotta go.
I love you. For all the
joy you brought to me. I love you too, Daddy. You're the one who saw me through. And thanks for everything.
Gratitude. Pass it on. A message from the Foundation for a Better Life.
Getting back to live action out of the injury timeout. Monrovia looks to be without the starter probably for the rest of the game. And McCoy Davis, we want to send him our well wishes as well. What seemed to be a pretty significant gash above the right eye.
Down right away. You know, his mother was over there and she's putting on her coat, and so they're probably taking him someplace, hopefully, to get fixed up. And I bet you can't keep him there very long, because he'll be wanting to get back as soon as he can. But yeah, we wish him the best. And
Rovia finds themselves down five on the scoreboard and now minus one of their starting five. I will say this though, Max Newman played pretty well the other night against Cascade, and he's the one that comes in for Davis here. Smith down the lane, got the shot to go. Sometimes you see a teammate go down, it wakes everybody up as well. See if this draws some inspired basketball from the Bulldogs. Lead cut down to three. Three-pointer contested, just a little short. Williams.
That was a wide-open shot. Just couldn't get it to go.
Smith again. Down the lane. No, there's Newman.
Oh, nice cleanup.
Thought Smith might have gotten away with the travel there on the play. This three.
Oh, boy, good. That was pretty.
Both teams have awoken here. Camden Chad knocks down the three. He's got seven now. We get a 30-second timeout in the action. So the scoring's starting to pick up for both of these teams. That three by Chad puts it back to a four-point game. Max Newman with that rebound and putback a minute ago gave him 2 points and three rebounds in the game. Pretty good work for a young man coming off the bench. Good drive by Smith a moment ago, and there's that Newman putback.
This just feels like one of those games that's going to go back and forth all the way to the end, you know?
Obviously, a lot of other games going on around the state. As those scores start to come in, we'll try to get some of those for you as well. Eisenhut able to shed the defense there. Smith seems a lot more active right now. Stripped on this play, though. Chad, pull up for three. Short. Battle for the rebound down low. They're going to call it a jump ball. It'll be Monrovia basketball.
Take a look again. They got time to get it here, Sean. Here comes the shot. It's off the front of the rim. Both players go up. Boy, tough to tell, you know.
Sieber with it in the corner. Back to Williams. Williams nearly traveled there. Smith. Starting to go one-on-one quite a bit, though. I would like to see him be aggressive in the flow of the offense. This turnover.
Yeah, that was not a good pass at all.
Dad's been more aggressive down here on offense for South Mont as well. Getting a tournament like this, you have South Mont and South Putnam, and man, it's been an internal man versus himself battle tonight.
Oh, nice.
And there's a lay-in for Camden Chad. He's got nine in the game now. Smith tries to answer on the other end, can't get it to go. That immediately putting pressure going the other way. No, Siebert with the board.
Yeah, a little fadeaway there. Probably not the best shot. It could have probably found something a little bit better than that.
Newman to the bucket and lays it in. Max Newman filling in for the injured Davis.
Yeah, just a freshman, too. Get the job done. I like that. See, I love the way. Go inside, man.
Swick. Been quiet since the first quarter. Believe it or not, McCoy Davis is walking right there in your background, headed back towards the bench. He may not be leaving.
He got butterflied and...
Swick for three, no good. Don't play a lot of hockey here in Central Indiana, but that young man might.
Maybe some street hockey. Ah, that's what you get with the freshmen sometimes.
Shuffle the feet.
Yep. But he's playing well. I'd like to see them continue to feed him inside, let him go to work.
Couple of scores rolling in at the half. Harrison leading Zionsville right now. I believe Marion is leading Hamilton Heights as well. Just heard that in my ear a moment ago. Both of those games at the half. Frankfort and LaPel doing work here in the second round of sectionals. LaPel up on Frankfort. Foul's going to send Travers to the line. Travers having a nice game so far for Southmont. Already exceeded his scoring average per game on the season. He's in double figures with 10. Back to a 6-point lead.
3 of 4 from the free throw line. Playing very well. Look at that, another turnover.
Push the other way. Kochel just got cleaned out that time. Credit the young man for standing in and trying to take one. Huge size differential there between him and Travers. Not often you find a young man that's willing to stand in front of a freight train coming down the tracks.
Picks up his second foul. Travers knows what to do, doesn't he? I mean, he gets the ball, he just goes in.
I like his aggressiveness tonight. He's really taking it to the Bulldogs so far. Sometimes you get in these games and you really like your matchup too, Pete, and I think that Travers recognized it right from the get-go.
There's a good look.
Yeah, shot of McCoy Davis. He's back out there smiling. See if he returns the game action.
They got his buddies back here with the phones out. They said, here, I got a picture of it. I got to show you.
Yeah, let me
we're making you famous.
You got a gash on your head. It was the size of the Grand Canyon here. Check this out. Four free throws in the quarter for Travers. He's going to come out and get a break. Played really well for them so far. 12 points in the game. Monrovia starting to slide now. Down by 8. Haven't had an answer.
Oh, man.
Somehow there was not a traveling violation. Aaron Smith gets the lay-in.
That was a great move by Luke Smith.
This one in the lane all the way to the bucket for Camden Chad.
Both teams now trying to get to the inside and do some work in there. And they're both successful at getting there.
Trying to run screens off the ball for Smith. Barabee trying to be his shadow. Going to get a foul against Southmont here.
That will be on Barabee.
It'll be number 12.
It'll be his first. Southmont now with 4 team fouls.
Get it in. going to make a move in the post. He does. Wow. Nice play by Sam Whitaker.
That was pretty. Where did Sam come from, baby?
That shot no good. Smith with the rebound. Pull up right from the lane and got it to go.
Luke Smith is feeling it right now, Sean.
The lefty's starting to find his stroke.
He is. He's not afraid to take the shot. He wants the ball. No foul there.
Chad with the block. Way Williams is acting, I think he's the one who got him. Four-point game. Third quarter. That one tipped
nice
away
hands.
Out of bounds by Newman.
Yeah.
These Mounties, just one sectional in school history, way back in 1994. A win tonight would put them in the sectional championship game for the first time since 1998. To explain how long that ago that was, that's the year after I graduated high school.
They lost to Noblesville 67-54 in the regionals. One game right after their sectional title.
This is a team that over the years, though, they've had some really good seasons. They play in a very underrated, in my opinion, Sagamore Conference, because you have teams in there like Frankfort and Lebanon. Crawfordsville's have their seasons. North Montgomery has had their years. Western Boone is always competitive. You got Tri-West, who's a tough team, and Danville this year. Williams gets hit on the way to the bucket. I mean, really, looking up there this year, Frankfort's one of the weaker teams in that conference this season, and they knocked off Lebanon on Tuesday to advance to the second round of sectionals. I can say that about the Hot Dogs. I'm an alumni. Williams, this is kind of where he started the other night in the third quarter. He started knocking down free throws. It continued into the fourth. Carried Monrovia to a victory. Gets him back to within two here.
There. Shooting perfect in the tournament.
1:45 to go here in the third quarter. It is a two-point game. A competitive, entertaining first game tonight here on MTC Sports.
Boy, really good crowd here to see this tonight.
Good ball movement leads to an open shot.
Good rebound by Smith.
Smith now with 12 points, 5 boards in the game. Eisenhoop, Newman.
Follow that shot, young man.
Tell you what, though, Monrovia has some players, some youth on this team that makes you go, hey, future's kind of bright for these guys.
Getting a little wild now.
It's turning into open gym. Chad, lay in. The big third quarter continues for Chad. He's got 9 in the quarter, and it's another turnover from Monrovia. Just when you thought they were going to get back in it, they're starting to slide again. Drivers will come back. Coach Sparks and the Southmont Mounties, this is his fourth year at the school. It's his second double-digit victory season. He went 16-6 in his first year. Had a couple of lean years, and now back to their winning ways, 10-12. And you're thinking Southmont is really the favorite to go up against Cloverdale. Swick with the take. Not to take anything away from Monrovia or South Putnam. Cloverdale the favorite to win this sectional. Southmont favorite to finish second. Monrovia trying to do something about it. Good
Boy,
ball movement.
Begging for it, and he got it.
Eisenhoop dials it up. We got a three-point game. That shot will not count. We got a whistle before.
Eisenhoop, man, I'll tell you why. He was sending up flares saying, give me the ball. Nobody picked him up.
Monrovia asking if there's time left on the clock. They're saying no. That's going to do it for our third quarter. We leave you with that Eisenhuth shot. It's a three-point game. 34-31 on MTC Sports, presented by Endeavor Communications.
Endeavor eShield gives you peace of mind that your home, family, and business are safe. eShield provides burglar protection, leak detection, carbon monoxide, smoke and heat detection, and asset protection to secure your valuables. And of course, there's 24/7 monitoring. Total Connect Remote Services controls your system through your smartphone, tablet, or any other wireless device. Call 1-800-922-6677 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details. Endeavor Communications, we protect what you cherish most.
34-31 your score, fourth quarter. Could be an entertaining one. Vaughn Walker, Pete Gasso calling the game for you this evening. These teams battling it out. Seems like every time Monrovia gets within one or ties it up, Southmont has an answer. They go on their own little bit of a run. Camden Chad trying to continue the hot shooting. Woo. Third quarter, misses this one.
That was deep.
Smith, step back, three, no good. He was trying to get it all back in one shot. Travers ahead. I'm not just going to kick it back outside. Wick, we saw him hit the three early. He had a two-pointer there in the third. He's been quiet.
Oh, nice job of keeping his foot from dragging his foot and switch, you know, not moving his pivot foot. He had to turn funny and try to get that up to John Williams.
Williams draws a foul. Four fouls on both teams now. Tieber versus Swick. Tieber in the lane. Does his best job at just getting that one up. He's going to earn a trip to the line. Chance to get it within one.
That Travers on that one. That's only his first.
Ball by the official. Tieber one for one at the line tonight. Broadcaster jinx is in full effect. 78% free throw shooter on the season. He misses that one.
He's been a little quiet here today, that's for sure.
The young man that averages almost 16 points per game. He's got just three. That four.
After three, lapel over Frankfurt right now, Sean, 38-32.
The shot by Travers off the mark. Ball caromed around. Eisenhuth will track it down. Tieber.
Thought about it.
Hey, dude, loses his
defender.
Oh,
there you go.
Shot too strong. Comes Swick in the Mounties. Swick goes right through the defender. Nothing there. First shot, no good. Swick puts it back in.
Nobody even collapsed down to him.
Four-point game. Coach Elliott up barking at the Bulldogs. Eisenhuth tried to get the and one. Can't get it to go. He'll go to the line, though.
I just left.
Four-point game. There's the drive by Eisenhuth a moment ago. Gets the free throw. 4 points now in the game for Trevor. Young man that shoots 47% from the line this season. Freshman Newman will check back in. He'll give Siebert a break. Eisenhuth gets them both. That's a good sign for Monrovia fans.
Keeping it close.
2-point game. Chad looking to penetrate, finds Swick. Traveling violation called from across the court.
Man, those are those little ones that just, that gets your coach fired up right there. Especially that hair goes gray or it falls out.
This late in the game, got to execute. Eisenhoop. Nobody picks him up.
Oh, boy. Shot an air ball on that one.
Chad looks ahead. Got Travers.
Oh, too
Travers
hard.
Travers leaves it short. Newman trying to dump it down low. That one tipped out of bounds by the Mounties.
Yeah, good look by Newman. He was looking for number 11 down low. Just missed him.
Look for Smith to try to get it back right here. He does. Good closeout defense. Farabee and Greg are two players that have come off the bench tonight for Southmont. I thought they've done a phenomenal job on Smith.
Farabee only two fouls on him. Still playing tough. Greg's been the same way.
Coach calls out the play. Eisenhoot will set it up for the Bulldogs.
Miss Whitaker down low.
Rovia can tie or take the lead. This
oh,
shot.
Not the best shot, but he got it.
Luke Smith going to the line.
You're kidding me.
14 points in the game for the junior.
Boy, he likes those circus shots, doesn't he?
89% free throw shooter on the season. He's just got a great touch. Pretty. We say it every time it comes out of a lefty's hand. For some reason, it looks better. Everybody says it. I agree with them. Chad down the lane, partially blocked by Smith.
Wow.
1 point lead now from Monrovia. They've trailed most of this game. Smith down the lane, up and under.
Oh,
got the roll.
Feeling it.
5 points in the fourth quarter. 17 in the game. Chad, little hesitation dribble. He'll be fouled by Williams. Monrovia, I believe this is their largest lead of the game, is 3. Tell me it was the first lead since they led 12-11. That was at the start of the second quarter. Chad gets the first free throw. Points now for Camden.
Yeah, these free throws are huge now.
This free throw will cut it to 1. He does. Smith, the throw ahead to Newman. That's too easy.
That was easy. Nice job by the freshman.
Good pass, baseline jumper wide open and knocked down by Todd. Just his second field goal of the game. Talked about those free throws a minute ago from Camden Chad. We've talked about Luke Smith only being a junior. Chad is only a sophomore. That shot knocked down by Smith. He must have heard me say his name again. Points.
He's having a great second half. Sure if they'll get John Williams again on this one. If they do, that's his fourth. Or if they give it to Newman.
His penetration.
Well, actually, it'll be his third. I don't know how. That got chased around, but I'm with you on that. I really thought that was the fourth.
16 points now for the sophomore. Calmly gets them both. Young man, and wise beyond his years, we'll put it that way.
We
Williams back to Sieber. Chad now picks up Smith. Sieber looking for help. Swick really coming out. And they're going to get the foul here. They're going to get Swick. They do. Really, it was good defense early on, Pete. Kind of bailed him out there at the end.
That'll be three on Quick.
A one-point game right now with Luke Sieber at the free throw line. He's one of the two starters for Monrovia that you really don't want on the line, the 78% shooter. 2 for 3 on the day, so he has missed one. Bomley goes the line and knocks them both down. Sieber and Smith trying to put the Bulldogs into the championship game tomorrow night. Does Southmont have anything left in the tank here? They've led most of this game. Chad loses the defenders, takes on the entire Bulldog team himself, and gets the bucket. 19 now for Chad.
Well, it was something else, wasn't it? How about that? What a game.
Smith. Step back. Well, I tell you, I don't know if I like that shot in that situation.
Sieber was wide open in the corner.
Southmont.
Help him out.
That one taken away by Eisenhut. They're going to say,
"Oh, really?"
Jump ball, and Coach Elliott is beside himself there momentarily.
Well, I tell you what, Sean, on that one, really looks like just a takes it right out of his hands. Take a look one more time. Ball comes up. Ugh.
A little bit of technical difficulties with our replay tonight, cutting off early. See if we can get that corrected in between games. Timeout taken by Monrovia. It's a full timeout. We'll step aside as well. 45-44. Back with more basketball right after this.
Lightning fast high-speed internet is only a click away. Through fiber optic technology, Endeavor Communications is able to offer internet speeds up to 1,000 megabits per second to stream movies, download music, watch TV and video clips, connect on social media, play games online, conduct online video conferencing, and is ideal for supporting all of your devices in your home or business. Call 1-800-922-6677 or visit our website at weendeavor.com for more details.
Back here with 2:17 in the fourth quarter. More scores coming in from around the area. Zionsville leading by 2 now over Harrison. Midway through the third quarter, Zionsville's come back in that one. Monrovia leads this game by 1. The scoreboard in the gymnasium has confused me all night now because they have Southmont as the home team playing on their home floor wearing the away jersey. Riddle me this. Monrovia looks to just kind of play keep away for a few. By a few, I mean literally a few, the last 2 minutes of this game. Eisenhut quickly, you'll see him get rid of the basketball.
Oh, boy.
Sieber turns it over. Southmont now with a chance to take the lead. Timeout going to be taken by Coach Sparks.
Good timeout, too.
Another full timeout allows us to step aside once again, get more messages in from our sponsors. 45-44 your score. The conclusion of this one headed your way when we come back.
Endeavor Communications continues to be the leader of technology in our communities. We provide crystal clear voice, super fast internet, exciting television entertainment, security for home and business, medical alert systems, IT services for home or business, and our new 4G LTE wireless telephone service with nationwide coverage. Call 1-800-922-6677 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details.
You see the scoreboard, 45-44. Southmont with the basketball and a chance to regain the lead here late in this one. Down low to Swick, going against the freshman in Newman. He'll draw the foul and head to the free throw line.
That's got Newman with the body, hands were straight up. He's doing a pretty good job there. Only number two on the young guy.
Swick gets the free throw to go. That'll tie things up at 45. Bud will come back in. Travers will come out momentarily.
One thing for certain, Southmont shooting excellent from the free throw line. Get the job done.
Till that miss there, Swick.
Only their second miss from there.
That miss, it leaves things tied up. Monrovia now with a chance to regain the lead. The pressure from Southmont nearly creates another turnover.
Somebody got to be open.
Smith doesn't care if anybody's open. He's no. open.
He says, I'll do it by myself.
Chad, they'll get him with the carry.
We got to love a guy that just wants the ball. Not afraid to take that shot.
That was big. The two-point lead. Now Monrovia, I'm sure, is going to get put at the line here momentarily. See Southmont go for the early steal and then foul late. Smith gets out and poked away from behind. Somehow comes away with it until Southmont loses it.
Oh, boy. They just got to be relaxed with it.
Sieber gets fouled going to the bucket.
Surprised they didn't call.
Even though it was a hard
foul there, but he was going for the ball.
Exactly. It was a hard foul, but I thought Todd did a good job of going for the ball. You see this just mayhem ensuing. There's the ball going back and forth between the teams.
And yeah, and you've seen come over the top and try to slap it away. You're right. It was hard, but it was all ball.
Now Sieber at the line. Misses
wow.
the front end of a 1-1. How big is this? Chad tries to get around the defense. Forces a shot up, but they're going to bail him out with the foul on the floor. They point to the floor. Boy, I thought by the time the whistle went, it looked like he was in his shooting motion. Doesn't matter. It's a 1-on-1 opportunity. The free throws are still coming anyway. The little things at the end of a game, Pete, they mean so much.
They do.
30 seconds left. You've got to box out on a miss. Chad with his fifth free throw of the quarter. He has 20 points in the game. This will tie it up.
Oh, and he gets the ball.
Hits the front of the rim, gets it to bounce over. We've got a good crowd in here tonight. Standing room only down here to our right underneath the bucket.
A lot of people here for this second game. They're getting a show now.
The fans taking it in, 47-47. Could we see extra time? If you're Monrovia, you take the final shot of the game.
Oh, definitely, yeah. And something inside.
They bring the double team.
Right there, Sean, right in that guy's hand.
You got to be careful not to foul here if you're Southmont.
Smith, pull-up jumper from inside the three-point line with 4 seconds to go in the game.
That was huge. Wow.
I don't understand how he even got the shot off in the first place. Defense was spectacular. The shot was definitely a two. Monrovia's coaching staff asking for the three right now. He was definitely inside the three-point line.
Oh, yeah, he was inside there.
It is a two-point field goal.
I'll be curious to see if now they put a little bit more time on the clock.
I felt like the timeout got there from the coaching staff. I thought the clock was good. They are going to put some time back on. They give them 5 seconds back on the clock.
That's a lot.
So 1.2 goes back on the clock, sets it to 5. We'll adjust ours to match. Southmont will have to go the length of the floor. Remember, in high school basketball, a timeout, you cannot advance it. On the made shot, Southmont will be able to run the baseline. Are there any flair for dramatics? We're going to find out. 5 seconds left in this one. Monrovia, will they pressure the basketball? They've got the tallest player in Newman down here. They're going to put him on the ball. Southmont with nobody on this end of the floor.
Swick, Travers, and Chad are the only guys who've hit a three here tonight if they go for the win.
You're going to get another timeout now that Monrovia sees what Southmont wanted to do offensively. Now they'll make an adjustment, expect for Southmont to do the same. They were running like a full court stack down here on the other end. Pete, I'm expecting Camden Chad to get the basketball.
That's
here
exactly
for Southmont.
Exactly who I would say. And if not him, you got to have Travers or somebody, probably Travers.
Even Swick, as quiet of a night as he's had so far with just the 8 points, always a dangerous shooter, a young man that shoots 43% from behind the arc.
I mean, you can use Chad as a decoy if you want some kind. I still think it needs to be in his hands. But those two right there are the players that you're going to want taking that last shot.
Every time I see a game get down to the end like this and the team's got to go the length of the court, you know what I think about? I think about the Valparaiso shot with Bryce Drew. I think about the full throw and basically the hook and ladder. It's almost like the football play. Bryce Drew knocked it down to give that Cinderella team a win in the tournament. Is there any magic in the stands tonight here?
About ready to find out.
49-47, Todd to inbound. They put nobody on the basketball. Newman's playing free safety right now.
You got to
get it in. They get it over the top to Chad.
Oh,
Chad's now
going to
take a timeout with 4 seconds left.
I love that.
And now they can set up a half-court design.
Well, I tell you what, you couldn't have gotten that to work out any better for you. I don't know if you can look at that shot again. I mean, that pass, but
to me, when
nice
Chad
pass.
Catches the ball, though, there, Pete, I understand the thinking and the logic. But when he catches the basketball, there's nobody else there. I mean, he's got the wide-open three if he wants it. He's got a good look at a mid-range jump shot if he wants it. We'll see if the timeout works here and they're able to draw up something nice and get an open look. But you almost like those scramble situations when they work. When someone catches the basketball, you let the momentum in the play out. But, of course, in the broadcast booth, it's easy for us to say, what if, what could have been.
And it did look like he had a little room. He could have advanced it and maybe taken a shot. I like this call. I like a play from the outside. You got two very good shooters here that you can try to get the ball in their hands.
It was obvious that was the plan from the get-go. If we catch immediate timeout, we're going to run a half-court set here. You're five on the floor. Travers, Todd, Swick, Chad, and Greg. They get it into Swick.
Got to go.
Got to get it up. In the
corner.
Good
to go.
Oh! Shot is off the mark, and Monrovia is going to escape.
with the two-point victory, 49-47. A great-looking play for South Mont. They just can't get it to fall.
I love the call. I don't care. You go for the win. That is gutsy, baby. Hats off.
We are going to step aside, take a quick break. We'll be back to wrap things up with the post-game show. Stay tuned here on MTC Sports, presented by Endeavor Communications.
Endeavor eShield gives you peace of mind that your home, family, and business are safe. eShield provides burglar protection, leak detection, carbon monoxide, smoke and heat detection, and asset protection to secure your valuables. And of course, there's 24/7 monitoring. Total Connect Remote Services controls your system through your smartphone, tablet, or any other wireless device. Call 1-800-922-6677 or go to our website at weendeavor.com for more details. Endeavor Communications, we protect what you cherish most.
Welcome back to Southmont. One final time, at least for this game. Southmont Mounties fall to the Monrovia Bulldogs by two. A huge shot by Luke Smith at the end of the game gives them that victory. Post-game wrap-up show brought to us by Endeavor Etex. Sean Walker, Pete Gasho here. Pete, that first game was phenomenal. We got another one coming. So if you're a Cloverdale fan, if you're a South Putnam fan, hang tight. We're going to wrap things up on game one here first. What's your thoughts on the first one?
What an exciting game. What was really great about it, we had all these fans inside this gymnasium coming in to see the second game, and they are all entertained by that last about 2 minutes. What a very exciting game, and congratulations.
Pretty awesome.
That was awesome, dude. I don't know what else to say. I mean, the play of Luke Smith was just tremendous, and, you know, you're looking for Luke Sieber on there, averages 15.6 points a game. He provided eight, so really, you know, Smith really took it on him to get it done here tonight.
Let's look at some of the scoring for Southmont. They were led by Camden Chad. He had 21 points. Travers chipped in with 12. The other player knocking on the door with double figures was Caleb Swick with eight. On the other side, Monrovia, led by our player of the game tonight, Luke Smith, 21 points. Just phenomenal. And that final shot against a double team, there was no way he was giving that basketball up.
I love the fact that Southmont at the very end decided that this was what they were going to do, and they went for it. And that is such a gutsy call. They had a guy wide open. Shot was there. It was there before the buzzer went off. It hit the rim. You take a look at it one more time.
Yeah, we'll show here you the we are. Play.
Inside.
Swick could have panicked here. I really thought when he passed it, there wasn't enough time.
And they did. They sucked the defense clear over like that, and they had a wide open shot right from the corner. What a – it was just a – I love the fact that they went for it.
That's a big shot, a big situation for Andrew Gregg. He's a junior on the team, shoots 38% from behind the arc. So they definitely got it to one of the players they wanted to see that shot go from. Just unable to get it to drop. Southmont will fall. Their season is done. Monrovia – moves on to the championship game tomorrow night. That's going to do it for our post-game show. We're going to step aside briefly. If you're waiting for Cloverdale and South Putnam, stay tuned. We'll be back on air in just a few moments with our pregame show for it. But for now, for Pete Gasho, for our director Kevin Gasho, and everybody behind the scenes, I'm Sean Walker. We appreciate you tuning in. This broadcast has been an MTC Sports production.